Amigo metalero,
hello, you metal maniacs.
La suma de testosterona más lucha de egos es una peligrosa ecuación que a veces lleva a catastróficas consecuencias. En este vídeo vamos a recordar algunos de esos momentos de máxima tensión en los que miembros de una banda acabaron resolviendo sus diferencias en público, no siempre de manera civilizada. Y cuando digo que las bandas no siempre resuelven sus diferencias de manera civilizada, lo primero que todos pensamos es en esos músicos que de repente se liaron a piñas en el mismo escenario. Un ejemplo reciente lo hemos tenido con la reunión de Jane's Addiction. Otro caso muy conocido lo protagonizaron Marilyn Manson y John Five. El actualmente guitarrista de Motley Crue era víctima habitual de los delirios de Manson en los conciertos de la banda. Seguramente había bastante de show en aquellos momentos, pero parece que aquí se les fue de las manos. Donde sí que no hay ninguna duda es en el siguiente caso. Las tensiones dentro de Poison se materializaron en este momento en un concierto de 2006. Otro momento de tensión evidente se vivió en una actuación de The Brian Johnston Massacre, cuando Anton Newcombe amenazó con despedir al guitarrista Ryan Van Creed en pleno concierto.
There's no more music until you get to me. We actually don't need you. Go, put my guitar down on the stage and think about what's happening. Unplug.
You better think about this one, man, because this is forever.
Y es que no fue la primera vez que pasó algo así con la misma banda. Y por supuesto que estos momentos de tensión no son exclusivos de las actuaciones. La adrenalina del directo seguro que ayuda a los músicos a saltar, pero la convivencia fuera del escenario con giras que pueden durar meses y meses y más meses tampoco debe de ser nada sencilla.
You're like weird little freaks. Mark Martin. Get ready for the sucker punch.
Let it go. Let it go. Oh shit.
Muchas de estas situaciones se dieron en décadas pasadas, cuando no había 700 millones de telefonitos y cámaras grabándolo todo. Estos son algunos testimonios de músicos que vivieron peleas dentro de bandas míticas, pero de las que obviamente no tenemos ninguna grabación.
I remember quite vividly Alex Van Halen, who of course is big, you know, he's the drummer, he makes his living hitting things with sticks. He had a big fight with Edward over what the set was going to be that night, you know, what song was going to be first and what was going to be last and everything. And remember, he had thrown Edward to the pavement, smacking him around and everything, but at the same time, He was cradling his little head so he wouldn't bash it on the cement because we did have another 3 sets to go.
We were all alcoholic. I've been doing martial art ever since I was a kid, and I beat James up because he kicked my dog. I'm on stage. Somebody knows I'm on stage, so what do? They jump through my window, take all my... I said, that's never going to happen again. So I got a dog. It was a dog more like an alligator with fur on it. It was a pit bull, right? So I took the pit bull up to rehearsal when I was in Metallica, and it stuck its little teeny feet up on the car of the bass player. James kicked the dog, so I punched him in the face. The thing was, is we all were such drunks. And when I got drunk, I got violent. When they got drunk, they got stupid.
Y también hay momentos en los que una inocente broma sin maldad alguna se puede hacer pesada y desatar un inesperado momento de tensión entre compañeros. Hay veces que no todo es tan evidente y podemos ver ese desgaste interno de los grupos con detalles mucho más sutiles.
No, I mean, he's not a happy person.
What do you mean?
What I said. You can't understand that, you can't understand anything. He's not happy.
What's the strangest request you've ever received from a fan?
The strangest request was having to do with a baby. And, a lady who didn't mind if I gave her one. That was pretty strange.
Oh boy.
I declined.
What's the most unusual gift you've ever received?
Most unusual gift?
A baby.
Yeah, the imaginary baby. But I think the best thing and the biggest gift we've ever gotten is 20 years of doing what we do. And that comes from the people, and that comes from their heart and soul. So that's a little more important than, you know, we can talk about, oh, there's so many women. Any idiot can get a woman when they're on tour, but this is a lot more important and a lot more heartfelt than the bragging about the other stuff.
Would you cut? Oh, hold on 1 second. Cut this off for a second.
Would you stop cutting me down in front of a camera? I don't go for that.
Go on.
I don't know, all of a sudden, like whatever I say, all of a sudden, don't listen to this idiot. Don't do that anymore.
Go on.
O directamente con declaraciones cruzadas que dejan claro que la relación de dos compañeros o ex compañeros es tan mala que cualquier malentendido podría acabar en más piñas.
He's an intellectual dwarf. I didn't say that. I mean, what I'm saying is he's insecure. He's... I didn't say that. I didn't say that. Yes, I did.
One of these days, when we're playing on the road, I'm going to attack Ian Gillan in the back alley. He's bigger than me, so he's probably a better fighter. So I'm going to do it with a few friends of mine, probably Swedish, and we'll beat him up.
We tried to be gentlemen about this, and I guess we're just going to get a little bit nasty right now.
Put it this way.
No judgment, no judgment. Just a fact.
No, wait a minute. Bottom line, his work ethic sucked, okay? Now, if he wanted to be in this band and be a team player, he would be here right now.
Well, what happened at the MTV Awards that changed the nature of your relationship with David?
It wasn't his onstage antics, which for one I thought was embarrassing.
And disrespectful to Beck?
Very disrespectful to Beck, as he's trying to thank, you know, people, his acceptance speech, whatever. Dave's behind him doing his shtick, you know, and it's like, ugh. I don't know. To me, it was embarrassing. But it was more so backstage, where he basically spit in my face. Everyone, you know, yelling, screaming questions. And Dave just wasn't answering any of them. He was doing his hop and bop and best piece with the pops. So I just kind of walked up and said, look, everybody, here's what's happening. Two songs, best of volume one. One of us would like us to do two videos. And that is it. If you think we're going on tour in the summer, forget it. We're not gonna go out there and take your money. And if and when we ever do a tour with Roth in the future, we'll have to write and record a new album first. Okay?
Now that's what he said. This is not what we're saying now.
No. I'm saying
this
is backstage, the press conferences,
right.
Okay? And I said December 16th, I need a new hip, okay? So that's going to throw a little wrench in the works. And Dave's vibe changed. Now, instead of coming to me and saying, hey, Ed, come on, we just not mention your hip thing. I had to go to him and go, Dave, what's the matter? What happened all of a sudden? You know, you're just all happy and stuff, and now you're like, he goes, well, hey, tonight's about me, man, not your hip.
Tonight's about me.
I just bit my tongue and I said, okay, Dave, the next one, you, Alex, and Michael do it, but answer the questions. And I will not mention my hip. And he, I'll try and do my best impersonation. I better not. I was ready to, you know, it's like all those years of right there. If you ever speak to me like that again, you better be wearing a cup.
Las diferencias creativas o la convivencia diaria durante las giras a menudo producen un desgaste evidente entre compañeros, hasta el punto que alguien acaba perdiendo los nervios y tomándola con quien tenga al lado en ese momento.
You're just sitting there going, I'm in a really pissy mood, and
I told you straight up that I was.
Right.
And what are you trying to do?
I'm not trying to do f***. You're just sitting here being a complete f***.
You're really helping matters. You're really good at that. I was straight up with you, and I told you I'm in a mood, and what have you been doing? Picking at me all night.
I realize now that I barely knew you before. I don't want to end up like Jason, okay? I don't want to be pushed away.
Y por supuesto que cuando se trata de repartir piñas, algunos músicos también han sido generosos con el público. Tienes en el canal este vídeo con algunos casos de momentos de tensión entre músicos y el público, pero vamos a añadir algún ejemplo más.
Give me your shit. Okay, so I hurt my neck somehow really bad, so I can't really move around very well. So if you throw something at me again, I'm gonna really be pissed.
What did you say?
Get in from me, folks.